And yesterday we were talking about naming the gifts, mm-hmm. and I thought about a story. My son, Andrew, when he was probably 5 or 6 years old, he had spent the night with my mom, and they woke up in the morning before the sun came up and to go for a walk around this pond beautiful. Near her house. And as the sun began to come above the clouds, he said, "Grandma, Grandma, look, the sun's rising." And she said, "Yeah, let's go sit down on this bench and wait for it." So they sat there waiting for it, and as the sun peeked over the clouds, Andrew pointed to it, and he said, "Look, Grandma, it's like a pretty picture, and we're in it." And my mom was just so taken away by this child who had framed this beautiful moment mm-hmm. and realized and recognized the gift and that he was in it. And one thing I love about your book, A Thousand Gifts, is that the Lord showed you and you show me and so many others how to frame the beautiful moments, the beautiful memories, the beautiful memorabilia in our home. And as I spend this time with you and I walk around your home, you live, your life is beautiful. But it's not because it's anything extravagant.
It's not.
It's because you capture beauty in the simple things and you put a frame around things and you've helped me do that. And I know that I can feel the change that God made in your life as I read your book.
I'm in process.
Enjoying the ring of cheese, you know, and your husband coming in and saying, "I love this because I love how happy you are."
Yeah, in the little small things, and I think
your circumstances haven't changed
at all. The circumstances don't have to change, and I think lots of times we miss art when we don't frame it. Okay, they had that study where they had that world class violinist. This is Josh Bell, who was playing the violin in a subway. I think it was in Washington D.C. Mm-hmm. And all these people walking by, who the night before his concert was sold out. Tickets, hundreds of dollars for these tickets, because it was framed, right? But in the subway, we don't see it as art. We walk right by it. Mm-hmm. And I think in naming the gifts, we're framing the moment and seeing us in it. But it's really letting us see God's signature on the masterpieces of all the moments, that he is the artist creating these moments. Mm-hmm. And it leads us to worship, mm-hmm. and it leads us to give him glory. And that's what mm-hmm. we're made for, mm-hmm. is to give him glory. Mm-hmm. So I think, yeah, it's like walking around with frames all the time. Mm-hmm. If you're walking in the front door, I have that frame that's mm-hmm. empty on top of the piano. Yeah. And you walk around with your life like that. And really what you're doing is to frame the moments and to give God glory. Mm-hmm. He's the one making the art. Because really, mm-hmm. in the midst of all of our messes, I mean, you've been here. The kids are wild and crazy. It's wild and crazy.
It's beautiful, though.
But
it's life.
It is life.
This is your sanctuary, and your children are your chorus.
They are the choir. They are.
I love it.
All of us get to be in God's masterpiece. Yes. What a tremendous humbling gift mm-hmm. it is, and to give the master glory mm-hmm. for it. What a story from your son.
Wow. Experience. Well, hey, as I read your book, I thought about that.
Yes.
And I love how you talk about, too, your camera became a hammer.
Yes.
That hammered nails into the places. And I want to, you know, I've actually started pulling out my camera more.
It is.
To capture those moments.
Because it's putting a frame around mm-hmm. things, right? And to take a picture, it's how you shift. Right? Mm-hmm. To not include something and to focus
absolutely.
On one thing. In our lives, we need to go ahead lots of times and just make a paradigm shift. I'm focusing mm-hmm. on this darkness. And if I just stepped over a little bit this way, I would step into mm-hmm. light, and it would, this moment that looks normal mm-hmm. from this angle is really a masterpiece. Mm-hmm. So having that camera, it puts the frame mm-hmm. around it mm-hmm. to see beauty in a place that my default is to whine and gripe mm-hmm. and complain about.
Mm-hmm. And to notice what's wrong.
Wrong.
And needs to be
I think that's exactly
what's
right. Because we want to make it beautiful,
yes,
right? As opposed to saying,
beauty.
Right where it is actually beautiful if I just change my perspective just a bit.
Yeah, it's so good. It so resonates with me mm-hmm. because as I have written and,
yes.
and the Lord's taking me through shifting out of a place of self-doubt into
a place of confidence.
It's not confidence in myself. It's confidence in his goodness, confidence in his promises.
I love
but it's shifting from the darkness to the light.
And that Godfidence, right?
Mm-hmm.
That Godfidence
mm-hmm.
of saying, I'm shifting from, I could focus on all of the things that mm-hmm. cause me anxiety, or I can focus on who you are, God.
Right.
When I focus on who you are, all of those things
mm-hmm.
fade away.
Yeah. Well, and like you, Sharon, one of my favorite verses is magnify the Lord
yes.
with me. Come, let us exalt
let's
his name
together.
You know, another scripture says the mindset on the flesh is death,
yes.
but the mindset on the spirit is life and peace. And these scriptures, like what you're learning and living, is a confirmation. It's giving
yes.
visibility to God's invisible character through the His scriptures are coming alive, yes, through these truths, yes, but not just in our heads. They're coming alive in our everyday lives. And so I just want to thank you for inviting me to magnify the Lord with you and to exalt His name together, not just in a big realm, but in the little realm.
In the little things. Mm. And for me, the gift of you talking about confidence in God, because it's so easy to focus on, we know that we are but dust. So the self-doubt comes so easily because we know we really are. And we are weak. But the point is to be weak enough to be used by Him and to focus on Him. Mm-hmm. And then all of us, it isn't about us. Mm-hmm. It's His strength. Mm-hmm. Thank you for the messages you bring.
Oh, thank you. Oh. I want to invite you to also visit Anne's blog. Please give me your blog address.
Aholyexperience.com, because really all of life is a holy experience, mm-hmm, not because we are somewhere, but because He is with us.
Absolutely. Aholyexperience.com. Please visit there. Watch how Anne has framed the moments and the beautiful artwork of her life, not so that you will envy her life, but so that you will begin to see God
in where you are, right where you are.
Have a holy experience right there
where you are
in your home. So we love you, friends, yes, and thanks for joining us today.